The founders are many old technologies. Most of the small and medium-sized founders have old technologies. Also in terms of implementing new technologies, it takes a long time and a bit difficult for them to do that. Also in terms of complying to environmental regulations, South African founders are finding it a bit difficult to do that as well. Also in terms of investment, the investment costs are high to do that. So hence the reason for them to experience those difficulties. Many shifts that have taken place over the last 10 years or so that I've been involved with the metal casting technologization. One of those have been the identifying the national quality framework, qualifications framework, and looking how the foundry industry is placed into that framework. The metal casting station identified that there was a gap. We initiated a study in this area, qualification standards were set. These were then submitted for approval. The South African Institute of Foundrymen have now taken over that role and are playing a very significant role in being able to assist the foundry industry to be able to improve their qualifications. With regard to that also, the Gauteng training center has been set up, and young engineers are being trained in that facility as well. With regard to skills gap as well, the MCTS together with Department of Engineering and Metallurgy initiated the master's course, or the master's degree is now being offered at the University of Johannesburg. The core mandate of the Metal Casting Technology Station is technology transfer and skills development. Together with the Department of Engineering and Metallurgy at the University of Johannesburg, the Metal Casting Technology Station is part of the Faculty of Engineering in the Built Environment. So the Metal Casting Technology Station is very much involved with the department to assist in addressing the foundry's needs with regard to training and also with regard to their qualifications. We just completed a study which was in partnership with our German partners on not only waste sand but other material utilization, for example energy, waste sand, utilizing of their processes within the foundry. So a detailed study has been done and a report to that effect is also available.
South African foundries are facing a lot of import leakage and this reduced their order book, and then it might have a possible impact in terms of the foundries in terms of their capabilities. In terms of addressing the skills challenge, a number of strategies have been developed by various stakeholders, and MCTS was involved in facilitating the internship program, which saw a lot of young people coming into an industry and improve their prospects. One of the highlights of the metal casting have successfully completed the project which it was dealing with the waste sand. Currently, the waste sand is becoming a challenge into South African foundry because it's more expensive to dump the sand than to buy the sand. So this it reduced their competitiveness. So metal casting was involved in that initiative in terms of seeing how they can improve the reuse and recycle of the sand and find an alternative way of using the sand.